Star Charger is knowledgeable in this matchup. We just have to see how he executes it. There he goes, right off the bat, scouting out that EX overhead, and always buffering the EX Rising Blaze just in case Rewind decides to get cheeky with that teleport. Rewind going for a forward grab instead, keeping Star Charger in the open space. Maybe he's going to try and go for a little bit more of a zoning-oriented playstyle. Oh, but a clean jump in! Star Charger going to get a nice chunk of damage here. Into the standing three lift. And the damage, 40%! There you go, keeping the distance. Not even going to try to challenge the anti-air. He's so close to taking this round.
Ooh, and
walk back into the anti-air fan. Brilliant stuff by Star Charger, starting off just as solid as we're used to seeing him.
And Star Charger, by making it this far, actually pushed Scar back into 10th place and is now in solo possession of 9th place.
And Star Charger just spending all the meter to make sure he doesn't let Rewind get any of that pressure going. Oh, no punish on the lift. The grab will do a little bit of damage, 12% there. Oh, and just narrowly misses that hit confirm. Still got a little bit of damage in there, but now he's just going to sit back and he keeps spending that bar. Going to make sure that Rewind respects the fact that he cannot just teleport in like that. And the beautiful thing about it is that Star Charger always has a bar meter to work with, it seems.
Oh, and the Savage Wake Up back throw!
That is a KP special if I've ever seen one. And a down one into the back one. Rewind answering back with a narrow round number two. Star Charger, sitting on a little bit over two bars, has the space to work with. He's in a good spot.
Oh, and whipping big there with Rewind. Star Charger's gonna make
Rewind needs to be more on point with these anti-airs. It seems like he's trying to attempt it, and he's just getting blown up, and it's causing these 40% deficits here.
And every time Rewind's gone airborne, Star Charger has made the conscious decision to just come off the bar. He doesn't want to deal with these jump-ins, with these teleports, with these shenanigans. He just wants to keep Rewind off balance.
And there we go again. Do not jump at Star Charger if you have those rising plants, the rising blades. He's got a bar to work with. He's gonna try to just wait it out. Really, no reason to make a risk. But Rewind getting some damage. Star Charger still with a little bit of a life lead. Goes for the assassin run. He's off of his meter. Trying to scout it out. A beautiful tech by Star Charger.
And trying to read out the teleport by doing the raw NJP. I think that there were a lot of reads.
And that's a tough spot that he put in, because now he definitely has to be feeling that pressure.
And that is twice that Rewind has thrown out that normal and gotten hit. He got hit for 40, and he gets hit for 31 here.
And the down one, down three into the back one again. Star Charger getting another clean jump in. Gonna do a massive amount of damage. Going for the bar. This is gonna do 40%, maybe even a little bit more. Gonna stick with the 40, still a nice chunk of damage. It gets a little, goes for the bar. I like how Star Charger's been approaching this matchup. But Rewind has a beautiful presence of mind to not fall for those staggers. Baits out the Rising Blades. This is a good look for Rewind. Oh, but no punish! And there you go, goes for the chip. Star Charger, very smart. Just not use the meter. Keep it simple, keep it sweet.
Oh!
Keep it in his favor.
Using that huge forward hitbox on the down two, we've seen YouTube videos of it, of people getting triggered how far it hits forward. Using it to anti-air the Princess, and Star Charger has a lot of meter here.
Now, we haven't seen the Star Charger special yet, and the Star Charger special, for those who do not know, is any block string into the parry. We have not seen that yet, and that really is what helped it work out so much, because he's so good at conditioning that. But at the same time, maybe the parry's not as much of a threat going up against Possessed, and Rewind showing just not holding anything back. Star Charger has three bars of meter to work with going into round number three, which is an absolute godsend if you're Katana. And just letting it rip. Not sure what he was trying to go over there. But Katana, no stranger to building some meter, already got that bar of meter back. Rewind being this impenetrable force of defense.
And Star Charger's gonna, I thought I was gonna say he's going into that round, he was in a perfect position because he had X-Ray, which is the biggest threat from Katana, to close out. And now he has nothing, and Rewind has the health lead, and this man is about to go down 2-0 now to Rewind, who is going to all but solidify his spot in the finale Star Charger Specials. We haven't even seen down one lift yet.
Nothing. We have seen nothing that made Star Charger Star Charger. Maybe it's maybe he's a little bit nervous of Possessed Kenshi. Look at the... I was going to say respect. Something's happening right now. And maybe I'm... controller... Alright, they're just going to play it out.
Not too sure, yeah. Oh, and look at the range of that overhead.
Oh, gets the forward two stream, but no hit confirmed. Beautiful backdash by Rewind. There it is. But you see, Rewind, just that presence of mind, goes for the down three, knowing that parries, that Star Charger's parry does not parry lows. It almost seems like Star Charger's kind of playing on tilt right now. He's trying everything in the book, and nothing seems to be working. And that's one of the beauties of being such a defensive player, Rewind, throwing Star Charger on a tilt by really just not letting him do anything.
And the back one mix. Rewind is now in full control, but oh, it actually goes through the armor with the down one DP and goes for the down one DP again and actually catches Rewind this time, pressing a button in the corner.
Here we go. Star Charger spinning a bar meter. Gonna get the 40% that he wanted in the hard knockdown. And the Oki just goes for a grab. Beautiful tech by Rewind. Rewind is not ready to give up. Just get a tech of his own by Star Charger.
And you cannot fall apart here if you're a Star Charger. You've already let one health lead go. You cannot let a second one go.
There you go.
Rewind. Might have been reading out a stagger there, pressing a button at the end. And now completely even into the even meter. Going to the final round. Coming off the breaker. And both bars, is Rewind there and was able to convert. But by then, the damage had already been done for Star Charger. But luckily, he's catching up immediately.
Yo, look at that, 38%! Yo, here come all those staggers. You see those chips just going away there. Star Charger's scouting out that EX overhead, but here comes Rewind with a beautiful hit conversion of the zone on the verge of making top 8. Star Charger needs to make something happen, find a way to open up Rewind, the first sharpen of the entire set. He can make this happen.
Oh,
this
no.
could actually be death with the sharpen in play.
Rewind didn't go for a mix, he just went for the straight demon and got punished. And jumping out of the corner! Oh no! And the neutral jump kick out of the float kit.
To get around that. And another clean jump, and if it's one thing Rewind's been lacking, it's his aim fire. He seems to be just a little bit off with the timing, and it's leading to this juicy damage from Star Charger. Down one, just beating out Katana's forward two there. You see now, Star Charger's not going to contest that teleport because he has the life lead. There's no reason to take that risk.
And coming off all of his resources now, if he falls to Star Charger, loaded.
The X-ray is out of place.
Man. Yeah, and
do some damage.
If Star Charger does not hold on to the meter, he wants to take it now. And with as little chance for some, for Rewind to come back as possible.
Wow, and Star Charger one round away from taking us to a game 5. Oh, it doesn't get scouted out. Rewind hits with the EX overhead. A nice grab. Going for the little bit of damage that's what Possess is known for. And gets the second bar to spend. Gonna do a nice chunk of damage. Hard knockdown. It just misses the combo. A little bit of an 18% Rewind, keeping the pressure going for as long as possible.
Ooh. Throwing some quick mixes, but that was a great block from Rewind.
The first time that Star Charger went for the back three into the EX fans, Rewind was there with a block.
And that
the EX overhead.
That may have been an obvious situation there where he was going to armor. Was finally negative. Star Charger could have finally checked him, and the armor should have been. No, man, throwing out the raw fan and eats the teleport. Not gonna break, he's gonna hold on to it. And Star Charger eating a lot of damage now.
Oh, just goes for the fan instead. Ends his pressure early. And Star Charger off of all of his meter just on the attempt to open up Rewind. Star Charger doesn't have that X-ray to work with now. Goes for the full screen assassin run. That's a nice little bit of damage, but he still
miracle
has
jump.
A lot of work to do. No punish. Oh, had the punish right there, but still drops it. 4-1 into grab. Rewind has the EX overhead to work with. Oh, and he missed the input? This is death.
This should do it. We are going to go to game 5. And out of nowhere, Star Charger looked to have thrown the match completely when it came up. And, you know, Rewind's not fully warmed up right now in this matchup. He's only got one game to get all the buttons right, all the little conversions there, all the combos down, and Displacer Raiden, some of the most execution-heavy combos in the game.
And the Star Charger scouting out everything that really Rewind is doing. 33%, the parry buff is still in the play. Here comes a beautiful 14% grab due to that buff. And Rewind really just can't get a solid hit. And that is actually going to do it. That buff is going to do so much damage. Just spending the meter anyway. I doubt Rewind was going to break. But nonetheless, Star Charger getting that first round. On the verge of being eliminated at the beginning, now is sitting on set point.
And what a turnaround it would be. Raw back two.
Oh, and look at the damage here. Gonna keep Star Charger standing. And an EX Assassin run baiting out that stagger.
Star Charger looking much more comfortable than he did to start us off, this man.
All of that damage. Back three stagger into the grab. I like it. Down three. And now EX Vicinity Blast not only giving Rewind that second round, but keeping Star Charger in the corner. Definitely a positive situation for Rewind. Star Charger sitting on two bars of meter, no doubt is going to slowly work his way towards that X-ray to look for a photo finish.
Oh, the 4-1!
Nico has to break early, that's a breath of fresh air for Rewind.
Rewind blocking a lot, giving Star Charger a bar and then some. Go for the NJP, trying, 3 NJPs in a row, trying to get, begging for Star Charger to press the button even. And even there, didn't fully commit to the forward 1-2 back 2, and he would have got the full combo in the corner. The decisions we make when everything is on the line are detrimental. And here we go, doesn't commit again, and he would have had another combo, but it's okay. That's going to be a full combo right there.
And he's going to keep him standing here. One more mix will do it, but he drops it. Star Charger Assassin running out of the corner. It's becoming a little bit of a scramble. Rewind blocks the forward 2 string, gets it down 1. And they're just trying to get any little bit of damage. Rewind
and finally, I was waiting for it. Rewind had done down 1 about 6 or 7.
Point that out, how Destroyer, sitting in 12th place now, the two people in front of him have been eliminated, so this is his week to shine. If he can make it to Grand Finals, that's a huge deal for him. But now, moving on into Dragon, Thorn Imposter against Deoxys and Katana. Deoxys, definitely no slouch with Katana. We've seen him do some serious work with Assassin. Oh, Dragon gets clipped by the forward 2 string. Beautiful corner damage by Deoxys. Keeping a nice commanding life lead.
Oh!
And just spending it! Wow! That is one hell of a statement. A round one X-ray with that life lead. Deoxys is not here to screw around. Round two. And you know what? In a way, I kind of agree with it. We've seen Dragon with some absolute miraculous comebacks. And of course, Katana, no stranger to building meter. But now Dragon's, even though he's taking all this damage, he's sitting on 3 bars right now. Imposter is another animal when he has meter to work with.
Yeah, so
immediately coming off 2 of them.
This is kind of a Katana special if she puts herself in a situation where she kills you with an X-ray in round 1, loses the second round, but you came off all your resources, and then she's built the resources to X-ray in round number 3. That's a legit way to play Katana, but wow, Deoxys looks strong early against Dragon. Dragon has to mix a lot here if he wants to make a comeback. And the shimmy into forward four.
Here we go. Oh no, he just drops a trance! And then the trade, definitely Deoxys. Dragon has just been this unstoppable force of destruction in the Combat Cup. Not only in the Combat Cup, but offline events as well. Deoxys, obviously no slouch, but at the same time, Dragon is definitely not going to be happy about how that first game went out. Very nice blast by Deoxys. What gets opened up by the Hellsparks? Dragon going to dish out some serious damage. And drops it yet again. No meter to work with this time. Deoxys waking up with 1-1-1 at the fam. Switching positions, Dragon no meter to work with. Deoxys could open him up one more time and close up this life lead. And you see, just going with all of this damage, all the chip damage, the staggers, the plus frames. Dragon still sitting on no meter to work.
Oh, and that was so sneaky from Dragon, because out there in the Nether Realm was a delayed meter burn on that Hellspark. And the moment that you hesitate to see it not happen, shoulder. That was so tricky from Dragon right there to close that out.
And Dragon just gets hit by the float shenanigans there. Trying to anti-air it, just a little bit off with the timing. Very nice shimmy into the grab. Deoxys looking much better here in round number two. Nice use of interactable to get himself out of the corner, away from those scary plus frames. Taking his time here. He knows he didn't need to take any risk. Opens Dragon up with a forward two again. Dragon needs to watch when he decides to hit a button. That mid-range, Deoxys has been absolutely dominating that range.
Here we go. Look at that meter on Deoxys.
You know he's looking for that X-ray. He'll do whatever it takes to get that X-ray going. But comes off the two bars. No doubt he's going to work his way down to getting it back. Down in the Hellsparks again, proving to be successful. Dragon goes for the back grab, 16% switching positions, but now has no meter to work with. Very nice, instant air one.
And if he'd have gone into fan, would have got a full conversion, but kept it nice and safe. Good backdash from Dragon. This time,
very
not
nice scouting
for it,
out,
but doesn't check it after the meter burn.
Deoxys can easily get. Oh no!
Oh!
Don't punish on the down two!
There we go.
That's a punish on the air fan. Beautiful stuff by Dragon. Tying up. Lunchables, crab, mac, and cheese. Call it what you will. Either way, it seems to be working. Deoxys hoping to make some. Hoping to create some different waves here with Test Catch. Dragon getting that trance going. Shimmy into the low again. Dragon's so good with throwing people off balance with the timing.
Keeping it safe with that amulet. And this is a matchup that Dragon has a lot, and I mean a lot of experience in. So it takes a lot of guts to pick these characters against Dragon.
Oh, absolutely. Even picking Katana. It's definitely a shaky call, but at the same time, Deoxys was doing very well. Now, going for Kenshi doesn't prove to be as successful so far, but you could tell that he knows how to deal with Shinnok. Dragon just has all the right reads right now. Finally goes for the back three, but still no punish on it. Deoxys opting for a little bit more of a full screen game this time around. Beautiful runner by Dragon, but just shy of that punish.
Going for the gimmick with down one. Into the Hellspark. He wants you to try to counterpoke. And there we go. The mix working now from Dragon. And Deoxys, if he blocks wrong, is going to have to. Luckily, didn't have any meter there to get a full combo. And what a crouch on the amulet. The full combo here saves his meter.
He's not out of it just yet. Down four in the teleport.
Dragon.
Oh, gets opened up by the low. That should do it.
Not watching his. Lies. Feet of all things, he could have eaten anything else and he would have been safe. Just don't eat the actual launcher.
That low demon stepping on Dragon's pinky toe. giving him that round. Taking us to a round number three. This is a crucial match right now, because if Deoxys can go up 2-1 against Dragon, he's going to be looking really good. But Dragon, beautiful wake up there, knows that Deoxys hasn't really been respecting his wake up options. Into the trance, Dragon looking to even out this life lead. Quick 16% grab. And this is a very even match right now. Deoxys used the EX overhead, does some nice chunk of damage. Dragon not sitting on any meter, could not follow up.
Ooh, forces the break.
Deoxys with the break. Scouts out. Just trying to chip out this time.
Oh, and no! A down one. Disrespecting with Dragon there off the...
It's just luck of the draw, man. Paulo's watching. He gets... We all know Paulo has a sixth sense of humor, man.
He's like, you know what? Let's just bump up the percentages a little bit on Sky Temple. Let's make it 20% rather than 6%.
Oh. And that down two from hell. Dragon's keeping the Deoxys as far away from him as possible. Here we go. And what is the mix? Nice box by Deoxys. Dragon spending the bar to keep himself at plus range, but Deoxys making good use of that corner interactable. Taking his time, you see that Deoxys is respecting Dragon's pokes, because those pokes and hell sparks are a serious threat.
Oh, it just does it! This man hits Dragon.
This is extremely scary, because that did not kill. If Dragon hits him once,
ooh,
luckily for Deoxys.
Luckily, that down two is amazing at anti-airing, especially neutral jump normals. I've tried to meaty that thing so many times, and it's so hard to actually beat out that NJP. But luckily, either Dragon went into Stemactor frames, or female hitboxes happened right there. I'm not 100% sure, but Deoxys gets a little bit of life here. And as you mentioned earlier, luckily, able to close it out after that X-Ray does not kill. And now Dragon... He's losing a lot of health.
I can't imagine how they were feeling, man. I was holding my breath during that X-Ray. I can't imagine what was going through their heads. But now Dragon, staying as composed as possible, has two bars of meter, spends one, gets the damage, right back into the trance.
We saw this.
Deoxys has meter to break. If he chooses to do so, Dragon not going to give him the option. Goes for the 60% command grab, but that does not kill.
Oh, presses a little bit.
Wow, and the flip of the elbow.
Just the tip of that shoulder. And just like before, Dragon mounting big comebacks. With Dragon, what a whip punish from Deoxys! Hello!
And that's what separates the men from the boys right there. Having the knowledge to be able to space out perfectly. And make sure that your opponent knows he cannot just throw out moves like that. Oh, the clean jump in punch, but no.
Oh, here we go. X-Ray's in play.
And look, Dragon is shaking.
Oh, no! Head. There it goes. You cannot escape long death.
It is absolutely impossible. Deoxys coming for a hell of a mind game. Here we go.
And doesn't go...
Not only Katana Mirrors, we're going to be seeing Dragon with Royal Storm.
It doesn't go with Mournful, and I've seen him pick Mournful a lot in the mirror, just because that Glaive is so oppressive, even full screen against the fans.
Jeez, fans, fan for fan. Going for the Reflag, a little bit of damage. Dragon going for the full screen hit confirm, beautiful stuff. Gonna put himself not only in the life lead, but in a good possession to just kind of step back here. But he's gonna go. And you know what? That was exactly what I was expect to see. Dragon has been hit by that X-Ray twice this set. And it's finally time. He goes up to Deoxys and says, you know what? I'm gonna give you a taste of your own medicine.
Precisely. He says, you know what? I've been there, I've done that, and it's my turn.
Owen. Doesn't get a hit confirm off of the end of that string. Deoxys getting clipped in the air. Needs to be very careful being in the air. Dragon just seemingly much more comfortable in this matchup. But Deoxys not out of it just yet. A couple down threes just to check him. Very nice tech by Dragon.
Ooh, the instant air fan to meet him. And Deoxys always got to keep it unbreakable. And gets a lot of damage off it. That's good to it! Deoxys didn't...
It's a very smart pick by Tigers. It's just going to come down to the idea of if he's comfortable enough in this matchup. Beautiful reverse tech and returns with the first hit. Now that buff is in the play. Weedy has to be careful using that bar meter. Very nice blocks. Tiger is very on point with his defense starting early here. Here you go, gets the take grab, reverses positions here, very smart. Scouts out not only the push, but the EX overhead as well.
And Jason, not with one of the best back dashes in the game, still in range of Tweety's back one. Jason's entire moveset is, I think, based on forward momentum and forward movement rather than retreating.
Oh, absolutely. That back dash is pretty ugly. I'm just going to be completely honest. Oh, and a back two anti-air, sir, get out of the air. Don't push that buff into play.
Oh, and just getting out of there. If that would have gone into any of the grounded armored attacks, he would have eaten quite a bit of damage. I mean, chained up command grabs from Jason are almost small BMBs, if not medium-sized BMBs.
God, and look at just the meter that Tweet is building. There you go, very nice blocks. Now Tigers not only still has a bar to work with, but he's unstoppable, so he's coming back at the end of this
round if he does what well. What entire stand one!
Gets the walk-up grab. Tweety has a bar to work with. Will Tiger scout it out? And just goes for the back three. Very smart by Tigers. Saving himself that bar, and we are going to round number three.
Oh, and overcommits to the back 1-2-2. Savage down two, though. Hello!
Look at the damage on that down two from that damage block. Oh, and a beautiful hit conversion of his own. Tweety, a never-ending combo, 28%. And he really can't do much about this pressure right now. Down one in the overhead.
But he's coming back to life.
Here we go. He has to come back. He does not have a choice. Tigers, one last-ditch effort here in match number one.
And the closeout off the top rope! Tweety comes off his bar, and that's gonna do it if Tigers would have got a clean hit.
No doubt Tweety knows how to deal with Kenjutsu, so Tigers is gonna really have to be on point. A whiff down two, not the way to start a Tweety getting the first hit. Now teleport pressure is still gonna be dangerous here, regardless of the variation that Tigers goes with. Another grab by Tweety. Oh, and just gets clipped. Tweety going for as much damage as possible. Spending all the resources. Tiger's just going to save his bar at this point. And down three into the overhead. Tweety with a extremely lightning fast performance.
Round two. Tiger sitting on three bars. Kenjutsu can get some massive damage going. And with bar can switch positions. He's got some interesting things that he can do, but just getting run over right now by the teleports that exist in Possessed Toolkit. And respecting the mix off the down four. And good block from Tweety.
Ah, just goes for the little punish, switching positions. I think it's the right call. The corner pressure is really what he does the best. And you see there, if he starts incorporating that, we might see something different here.
Exactly. I was about to bring up that's something that he has to implement if he wants to try to open up Tweety to complete the Jason package, and that is tick throws. We see it so much from guys like Sonic Fox. Back one, tick throw. So effective, and that...
Wow!
Back two, and the neutral hits everywhere. Man, just swings to the skies, a double uppercut.
Jason with some of the best pokes in the game, being able to really disrespect pretty much everything. Down three in the choke. Not the tick grab I was thinking, but works nonetheless. Tiger's ready to pull out every last trick in the book. No doubt, if he can even out this life just a little bit, he will come back this round.
Oh, and...
No, and he spends the bar.
Oh, very good. Knocks him off that armor, and very good.
Wow.
Throws the 50-50. I mean, there you're fearing the big boot so much. The plus frames... The active frames, the recovery on Big Boot are disgusting to deal with here in the corner. He doesn't have... And the tick, the true tick throw!
I have never seen a down three tick throw in my entire life from a Jason player.
Tigers, and that looked like it was gonna drop.
Oh, gets opened up by the back one. Sweetie eating some decent damage here.
And there's the recovery of that big boot. It's so hard to deal with. You can't even press a button. Ooh. If he whiffs. Big conversion! And the takedown again! One more hit! And that's gonna do it! Titanium Tiger stays alive here and looking so comfortable, re-going back. With that win, Tigers is able to play a little more of a mix-up game because now he has the conditioning of the command grab in the mix. So, you know, tick here, tick throw here, commitment there. You can mix it up.
Oh, and a very narrow miss on the interactable punish there. Titanium Tigers has not been able to do anything this round. Going for the breaker, hopefully making something happen. That's looking like that was a massive mistake. And there we go. Definitely not coming back after that. Tweety on set point now. Tigers, an unfortunate break earlier, now doesn't have a lot of meter to work with, but a nice kick confirm of his own. Going for the hug to switch positions, and here comes that buff.
Ooh, and walks forward into a back one from Tweety. Tweety was able to hold on to some good meter going in round number two, and that is just mental momentum. And Tiger's holding all this, and he threw out a back one. He should have simply armor choked it, do something to get him out of that sky. Jason does possess an air throw as well. Not the greatest, and now he's on full life support.
And he has a lot of work to do, but it can be done.
Oh, this is so scary because he cannot armor break anymore. He has to hold this. Oh my gosh!
No way! No.
This isn't
gonna
kill.
It's not gonna kill.
Oh, not like this! No. The meaty wasn't good enough! No! Not like this, ladies and gentlemen!
Believe it, he missed.
A Goro Mirror! Here we go! The hypest thing on God's green earth right now is a Goro Mirror here in Mortal Kombat X. Masters of Combat!
Oh. My god, I never thought in a million years I would see a Goro Mirror at this level, at this stage in the game. A beautiful backdash! Next, keeping the plus frames going. Plus again. More plus frames. And look at the chip damage. Sonic Box. Still has a lot of meter to work with, but now Nyx is in the lead. Another down one command grab. Oh no. A downward command grab of his own. We're going to be seeing a lot of this, I think. Oh, no.
Oh, it didn't have the stamina to place, but he could chip out of the X's it, but reversal spin from Sonic Fox.
I can't. It's really hard to keep up with this. All right, but Sonic Fox closing out with the first round by the skin of his teeth. Next, keeping Fox in the corner. Very smart. And his meter build is so insane. Yo, goes for the raw command grab. No, plus frames again. Down one into the spin. Plus frames again. And just an absolute mauling in the corner by Nyx.
And Sonic Fox holds on to so much bar and getting the startup of that projectile. And that's twice two projectiles have gotten Sonic Fox hurt here.
Very nice scout by the projectile. Sonic Fox teleporting in, running in with the whiff punish of his own. Gonna spend the bar, and here is all of that movable damage that we get to see. 35% hard knockdown, and just the wake up armor.
Well, swinging right now, the down one range working for Sonic Fox. And Nyx are blocking out, he scouts out the tick throw.
Sonic Fox has two bars of meter to work with. A run in, unfortunately, didn't have
enough. Goes for the kill and a down two, but Sonic Fox blocks it out.
No way.
And that's gonna do it! The explosion! So close to start us off. That looked like a true mirror.
That was a hell of a match. We'll see how Dragon Naginata works out for him now. Another two for two with those backdashes. But Dragon Naginata is one of those variations that, although not really slept on, I feel like people still aren't prepared for it. So maybe Nyx is going to have some trouble with this. Again, Dragon Naginata really known for the little bits of damage, but still can hit like a truck, as we're about to see. 28% meterless off of pretty much any conversion. Nice scout on the armor, but still gets the second hit. And we're seeing virtually safe.
Oh, a great little profile on the projectile, and using that pull, that three-quarter screen normal to close it out. And Nyx, this is definitely a matchup that seems on paper tough to deal with. Goro's limbs, not the biggest, doesn't have the best anti-air options, and his mobility is lacking. It's a lot of ground game from him.
Yo, Nyx really wants to stay up close and personal for as long as possible, but Fox is so good at just building enough meter, and his meter management altogether, it's just been really hard to deal with. If you're Nyx right now, you're trying to figure out some sort of way to deal with this, and that was a lightning fast.
Number one key thing being is mobility and range safety. I mean, she really does have it all.
But I mean, even taking that analogy a step farther, you take a look at the mobility that Fox is implementing with Dragon Naginata. You know when you try to swat a fly and it moves so fast that you forget where it is? It's a lot like what's happening right now. You know, and just as quickly as it started, a beautiful hit conversion from downtown. 27%.
And great.
Narrowly missing that wood finish. And just look how fast he's depleting Nyx's life bar. Nyx not out of it just yet. Could possibly get something going.
And we see this all the time from Revelethe. Just the mobility. Straight hits.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Oh, going for the EX projectile.
He tried to make it work. Yeah. You know what? It was a nice idea because that might have actually killed. That does a lot of damage. But at the same time, it's a very risky move against a character like Anya. Wow, and just using the bar to trade its armor. Again, another 17%. Those little hits adding up so quickly. Oh, gets a clean 403. Gonna get the hit conversion. Keeping it nice and simple. 36%. A nice amount of damage. But here comes Sonic Fox with some damage of his own.
Sonic Fox has the meter here, yeah. At any moment, any kind of mobility that Dragon Knight has to try to close the gap, to try to get in, if those health sparks are there, and the teleport could catch a stray air-to-air at full screen. But right now, Sonic Fox all over it. He does have all of the matchup knowledge in the world against Imposter, playing Dragon so many times week in and week out, and looking very good against him just last week in Top 8.
You look at how fast-paced not only this match is, but just any match in general with Dragon Naginata. You have to be really on your toes to be able to punish that character, and especially as Imposter, who relies on teleport pressure, Fox is making that next to impossible to do. Keeping the distance here. Fox has no reason to really go after him. He's gonna let Nyx just kind of like hang himself.
Oh, no hiccup from into the trance there from Nyx. Instead he comes off the bar and goes into the command grab.
Oh, look at that damage. Oh, miss the meaty. Now, this is a really, really uphill climb. Okay, so he just goes for the wake up. Either way, it would have been chip out. Very smart by Nyx. Put himself, arguably, one of the only rounds he's taken this set. Just keeping the blocks going. Very smart. Plus frames in the play. Oh, and Fox not scouting out that shoulder charge. Beautiful stuff by Nyx to get Fox after that bar.
And there's that Hell Spark stopping that momentum in, but teleporting through it as Fox spot. Getting behind it. And getting the corner push here, and the savage down two from Nyx. There we go.
Looking like he's finally starting to realize the holes in that Dragon Naginata.
And teleporting on the recovery of the pogo dance. This is insane.
Oh, just narrowly missing that shoulder charge. Goes for the run-up grab. Nyx has no meter to work with.
Oh, and gets it through it! It looked like it didn't, but Nyx...
Situation. This is still familiar turf for Nyx. Fox isn't used to being in a Game 5 situation.
And this is a different Imposter Shinnok, so a couple of things that Nyx throw at him that are different from the patterns that he's used to from Dragon could catch Fox off guard, but that teleport is not any different, and he has stand one that teleport. Four times in a row, because I think he did three straight times against Dragon in top 8 just on Wednesday, and he's 1-for-1 tonight.
And Nyx is going to need to be much, much more conservative when he's full screen. Ooh. Running in like that is not going to get the job done. And now Fox sitting on set point after what seemed like a very swift first round.
And Nyx came off the bar for the trance, but waited too long on the forward four. I think he went for the shimmy, and Fox didn't fall for it with the backdash.
Fox sitting on 3 bars a meter. Wow, and Shinnok's teleport beats out Sectors. There's a nice whip punish. Nyx not going to break here. Going to hold on to his meter in hopes to make something happen. He's going to be eating another 12% grab, and this is going to put him slowly into that danger zone. Now spending both bars to get the combo. Doesn't go for the mix at all. We're going to keep it simple. Very nice idea not to go for the backdash, knowing that Sector scored 2, and this is actually going to do it. Fox with a nice hit confirm, taking it 3-2 over Nyx.
And did he just... Okay, he missed this fatality twice.
Oh, it's not even if it's a faction kill.
Triborg wins.
You know what? That was a faction great showing by... Time.
Fight. Yeah, so it has to be a give-and-take competitor. He's got to test that early and maybe cancel into a block and try to bait out the fade and get Simij off the bar for nothing.
Down 3 into the grab. Very nice play, competitor. Slowing down Simij's pressure. Gonna, like we see, he's going to try and stay on him for as much as possible. And there's that EX phase shift. He's going to need to be very mindful of that in this entire set. And that tricky, we say it every time, what's the golden rule? Do not jump, and more so, do not even bother trying to anti-air. Simij or Molina. You know, runs up grab, beautiful conditioning by Simij. Simij is really just an absolute monster when it comes to conditioning.
Yeah, and you say, you know, don't try to anti-air this woman, and, you know, she controls both sides of that. You don't jump with this woman, and you don't do anything when she jumps against you. It's a frightening experience, let me tell you.
And Simij is the best at abusing such strong tools. Simij is taking his time, there's no reason. Oh, very nice hit conversion. No plus frames on his side. Nice scout by the phase shift. Oh, but doesn't watch his head and gets open. Didn't challenge the anti-air so much. He was looking really solid there. You know, knows the plus frames in that, very smart, but Simij going with that rapid pressure.
Oh, it gets the
4-3!
Hello.
No, 1-1 into reverse grab, very nice by competitor. Doesn't watch for that EX phase shift.
And just like that, and now he has to hold. And Simij walked him down and waited so long. Competitor could have pressed the button, could have woke up with something, but Simij so comfortable, he just walked forward and just, you know, it's all good. What's for breakfast? I've got all day.
There you go. Very nice. Down 3 into a forward grab. Very smart. Gonna opt to go for a little bit of a different idea here. Very nice tech grab by Simij. Exchanging posts, getting the forward 2 to connect. And here comes competitor.
And doesn't watch out for that bar. If Simij has 1 bar, there better be some respect on the screen. And again with the 4-3, opening up competitor. Luckily,
very nice. Third time is not the charm. Oh, but this is actually, that's going to be death, isn't it? After Chip, that should pretty much be death. and just like that, down three and a down one. A reverse 3-0 on Samij is something almost unheard of. But a standing one anti-air, very nice.
And a random stat, Samij is now 115-12 on Sundays in the Combat Cup. That's 115 games won, and he's only lost 12 games on Sunday this season. Whoa.
And I laugh because it's such a scary stat to have.
Whoa.
12 losses in the entire season is nuts.
And that's just game set. I mean, it's the start of, and that clone, luckily, hitting that hitbox of Melina, and he has to watch out for the fade here, Fairy. Is that the clone? And wow!
That was so smart, and this should end up just being chip, but it catches the backdash anyway. Samij on set point against competitor. Round two. It's just a really, it's just tough to deal with. And a nice down one into reverse. You're gonna keep competitor mid-screen. The hope and Samij hoping that he stays away from that corner.
And he's gonna hit stun here and puts you in a respectable situation. You have to respect the plus frames off that side and just throws you. And he could have just mixed, he could have staggered. So much that this character has at her disposal, and Samij exploits it better than anybody.
And that was so good. That jump back. And he's going with pumped up jacks. What am I looking at right now? I literally can't even.
Maybe he knows the tech. I mean, I like pumped up. Day one after the patch, I got to train with a pumped up player, and I was like, man, he feels really strong in this build. That gotcha grab is monstrous. It will hit anywhere if you are airborne, but newbie, playing lights out right now. But what's nice about that grab, 22%, it's a BMB. But the thing is Jax against these heavy zoners in this build? Very hard to deal with. He does not have that EX launcher read on a projectile that he had before.
This is not looking like a very good pick for Illusions right now. This is gonna do a lot of damage. Illusions knew he had to break that. If he gets opened up in the corner, that is gonna be absolutely death. And just goes for the one more overhead, trying to get as much damage as possible. He's been really crisp with those ground pounds. But newbie is always seemingly scouting that out. Another breaker by Illusions, and just the follow-up. That was so, maybe he took that first game to just kind of feel out what newbie does, and maybe Reptile was the right choice for him. Oh, but a beautiful scout on the EX live. No punish, but managed to get a nice little combo here, and we're going to be seeing a lot of zoning in this variation.
And if Illusions can get a health lead, or even get or just the first hit, those Acid Spits win the trade. Acid Spit does a great amount of damage, especially after the last patch, but they did buff it. I can't remember if it was last patch or patch before, but did get a damage buff.
Wow!
And but newbie, we mentioned earlier, the speed that this man's coming out at? Full throttle. He doesn't want Illusions to breathe.
And especially as Reptile, that's a very good game plan to have, because Reptile has some scary mix, man. Oh, gets opened up by the back too.
Oh, very good from newbie. Doesn't want to eat the mix. That would have been a forward four slide into a full combo because it's unblockable.
And another EX slide and another armored Kano ball. Wow, and that is as instant as it gets. Mm. And a forward two, just stuffing it. Hitting newbie in the gut. Now, both players virtually even on meter. Wow, and that down two. And another wake-up Kano ball. Illusions has to start scouting that out. Oh, and another missed punish on the EX line. And now newbie is like 8 for 8 on what seems to be those wake-up Kano balls.
Oh, no full combo punish though on the dash. We see that so many times here at the Combat Cup. And the block on the 4-4 slide, but no punish. And the acid bubble is going to close it out. It hit him after the... I mean, 150-50, and you could potentially, you know, eat half health. If he's got the bar, he can put up another Basilisk. Put all those acid bubbles, like, guarantees more pressure, guarantees more mix. I mean, the 4-4 mix-up's always been strong for Reptile.
Wow, nice little 11% there. Newbie is not winning this full-screen game. He's gonna need to be careful.
Those instant balls, wow! So fast from Newbie. His every time that he baits Illusions to pressing a button, they have been sitting there waiting for him, and that's going to chip out. You're using the hit stun off the dagger. The quick recognition from Newbie to see that it hit has the plus frames. Walk in back one.
Newbie's still doing a very good job just keeping his composure against Reptile, who's just an aggressive machine. Wow, and that backdash was so close to not working. Newbie still trying to get something going here. Gonna go for a little bit more of a zoning playstyle again. It's a full screen Kano ball.
And the block again on the forward force slide. This is great blocking from Newbie. And it's trying to clutch out. And another acid ball from Illusions. Clutching it out. This is getting down to the wire again, even on meter.
And that is such a heartbreak. Newbie could have actually already been on set point if he didn't drop that punish, but even now, getting some really nice damage. Illusions deciding to drop the end, to break the end of that combo.
And thank God Newbie got the punish on the dash this time around, and the laser anti-airing!
Another EX slide.
That's
Newbie sitting in a good position, but now he's gonna eat all this juicy corner damage.
I'm shocked that Illusions didn't go for a Basilisk there. This is a scary situation. Trying to get on Kano, and the punish wasn't there, and the instant Kano ball again!
How instant can you possibly get
him all the way down here? The man's hand...
That man beats the hell out of the stick for those that
he does.
Yeah, you hear that shit from the other side of the venue at offline tournaments. But either way, this man putting on an absolute beautiful showing.
Illusions.
But this is really going to test his defense. Illusions going Warlock against Newbie. You take a look, aside from the characters, Newbie does not like being locked down. And Juan has a very nice mixed opportunity with his runes. Oh no.
And good.
Very nice. Had the break there. Newbie opens him up in the corner. It is absolute death.
He was only one hit. Wow, what a great whip punish with the sky drop. If Illusions would have eaten... Oh, never mind. I take that back, because that laser actually would have launched meterlessly. I was going to say, if he would have taken one more hit, may have gotten Newbie off the bar. But wow, open starter from Newbie.
The whip punish on Juan's neutral zone punch, no doubt.
And
look at this damage.
Steamrolling right now. Cybernetic Kano. But no punish, though.
What?
And the scoop back into the corner. Raw scoop.
No. You will obey. Not like this. If anyone can make a comeback like this, Illusions can.
This is gonna... He's gonna try to force a break. Oh, no!
He has to break.
And makes it over the dagger! Into the jump kick!
Here we go. This is gonna be the epitome of mix at its finest.
Oh, but no!
Doesn't get the hit conversion there.
No trance there. Great anti-crossover with the down three, but no conversion from Newbie either. Both these guys dropping conversions early. And that kick! So fast. Great check.
Das Boot!
And he's matching projectile mid for mid with that kick.
Wow, and just letting go of block there after the jump-in punch. Newbie's got to be careful of that. Illusion's going to make full damage out of this. A little bit of meter building at the end. Normal wake-up ball. Kano ball.
That was patch one MK9 wake up Kano ball. Whoa, the down four beating a sky drop. Rest in peace, sky drop. Newbie was right there on the cusp of taking that round right out of Illusion's hands, but now Illusion's finds himself on a match point.
Finally getting something going. Here comes that mix that Cutthroat has been known for.
Wake and up, Raw Scoop!
You guys need to chill, okay? We get it. There's savagery. Didn't have the meter to break there. Gonna break early, does not let the combo continue. Newbie's gotta stay a little bit more patient here, being in the full screen. Down one in the scoop again, proving to be sufficient. Newbie is not being patient enough with this full screen game.
Oh, forces the break. That
had the break there.
Huge damage in the corner.
Down three in the scoop again. No. One more mix.
Oh no! And we're going to a final round! We're going to a final round here, ladies and gentlemen!
You felt the panic in Illusions to be able to not say, oh no. Look at all the damage.
And that
32% is in the corner. Power is in play.
And that's finally off of right Oki from Newbie, beating out the raw wake up from Illusions.
Oh, gets a little bit of a hiccup from there. Very nice. Down four.
Down one,
down
scoop.
Down one in the scoop again. So unsafe, but still seems to be working. Oh no. Beautiful tech.
He's and that's going to do it.
Cannonball does it.
Newbie.
Fares against the insane mobility that is Dragon Naginata. And now, Destroyer's Tremor has been getting better every single week. Oh, just misses the combo there. Very nice. Flexed on him right there. Beautiful block there. Unfortunately, can't really get a punish.
On the multi hitting, yep. Revit's playing this perfect. Playing keep away.
Destroyer's having a lot of trouble getting something started. Decides to risk it all. Put himself in the corner. Misses the input on the flex.
Ooh, no!
And the round one X-ray. I don't think this is good. No, that is not going to kill. It's going to put him in chip territory. But at the same time...
And he went for the high!
No.
Not like this! 3 bars of meter for nothing now. Circus Destroyer has got to be feeling that one.
That's probably the easiest way to put somebody off there. Immediately regretting that X-ray decision. Oh, it doesn't work a second time. Wow, and some little tricky setups here. I don't know what is happening right there. And just eating through that armor. That flash parry is not going to be a thing in this matchup.
And rep it all over Destroyer.
Wow.
He may have to force him.
At the same time, you know, Destroyer has had a rough start to Season 2. And he started really coming alive towards the second half. So even now, the stats, if you look at it from recently, he's been on a hell of a roll lately.
Yeah,
but
he really...
Leaping, on the other hand, is just... He's just an insane player.
He really came to life after playing offline and doing well against Sonic Fox at next level battle circuit. And since then has found kind of refound his groove here. Because he was one of the biggest threats in Season 1. And I believe he finished 4th in the finale. He did a fantastic.
Oh, absolutely. Wow, and just drills right under all those lasers. And you see the patience that Red Leaping needs to have. Oh no, he gets opened up! He's dead? Oh my god, Revit Leaping, please.
Round two, fight!
Yeah, it gets him with the interactable, or stops the interactable from coming into play. Destroyer quickly switching positions.
Oh, went for the double NJP, but Revit actually beating it out before the active frames came out on what I like to call the claw, and instead of punishing that scimitar stab, I think he caught Destroyer blocking low with that pogo stick and caught him pressing a button again.
Oh, and an uncharacteristic drop by Revit. Do a good amount of damage, big boot, and now the smart disc in the play. Oh no.
Savage down two and gets around it into the X-ray
wow.
of his own. He said, sir, I'm going to teach you how to X-ray properly, and that is to use it to finish your plate.
That.
You really have to wait and then try to read it with an NJP or a down two.
Oh, no punish on that down two there. and gets opened up by the overhead again. Destroyer needs to watch his head right now. So, some safe chip. Oh, Trey's beautiful hit conversion. But not scouting out that armor.
Everything going right for Revan. Every air-to-air, everything that Destroyer has attempted to try to swat that fly, as we talked about earlier, has had no effect on Revan. And I don't even know what that was. She just swung the pole and clipped this man into the next round. Whoa.
Revan leaping on set point of making pretty much quick work of Destroyer right now. Destroyer needs to make something happen if he wants a chance in the finals. Remember, he is sitting there at the very bottom of the top 12 in points. So winning this set is absolutely crucial.
Get a big boot, get some plus frames. And both of them, another big boot! And Revit just wanted out of the corner, it seemed, waking up drill kick each and every time. And not like this if you're Destroyer. Not like this. Forces the break. Meter. And now he has the bar going in the final round where another X-ray could be in play.
Every little bit is going to count here. Beautiful neutral dump punch, but no follow-up. Unfortunately, it gets opened up by the overhead again. And that's just faking him out every single time.
And he's going to use it for the 18%. And he's got two more in case Destroyer tries to pressure or Oki him again.
Wow, smart this, nearly this. That jump punch was from all the way downtown.
And look at the damage here from Revit! Whoa, and he almost finished it off!
Wait a minute.
Oh!
And still can't break that armor. And Revit taking it over Destroyer in a quick 3-0. Destroyer.
It's been fantastic to watch as the Elder God himself seems.
And BKiff has had a mean displace of Raiden, so we'll have to see how that goes. But Yellowmaster going with high tech.
BKiff did have a huge highlight in season number one, the infamous comeback on the teabag from Slayer. But we'll get into that later. And oh, go for the mix off the hit stun of 1-2-1-2 Yellowmaster. And he's been testing people early with high tech these past few weeks.
Well, it's another one of those obscure variations that we don't get to see. So if they don't know how to deal with that ridiculous pressure, they're in for some serious chop. Look at all of this pressure, and more so the amount of chip damage that Young Monster has been dishing out. No, it's not gonna kill, but it's gonna be dangerously close.
Oh, the comebacks have been insane by these brothers in the past two games. And you could just feel it when BKiff didn't go for the kill. He was a little bit stingy with that bar. You know, at worst, he would have spent the bar and forced Young off two bars. At worst.
Wow, just letting the Superman hit. Very nice blocks by BKiff and what seemed to be a punish.
Oh, what a reversal on a run under and gets the stanky leg, and oh, here comes the tricky stuff. But offers out.
Get some nice damage in there. Gonna follow up with some corner pressure. A tricky setup there. BKiff not done just yet, but the trade. The monster pick game number one. BKiff, I'm sure he's gonna be able to adapt at some point, but he's going with Master of Swarms here.
And already getting opened up by the two orbs on the screen that does create that force field, as it were. And yeah, I like what you said, where you kind of test the waters with this variation of Jackie, where it's just, you know, a lot of staggers, it's a lot of plus frames, and if you want to go for more damage quick, it's almost the same game plan as Shotgun, but the mix goes into more damage. Or you can opt to fall back and go to a more zoning variation with full auto. So, you know, you can really test the waters and then change it up. Yeah, it's actually gonna kill!
Here. It's just the damage that Young Monster can dish out as high tech. And you see now he's trying to stay up close on BKiff, knowing that he doesn't want those orbs to even come into play. No, and just the conversions all over the place today.
And I think that he missed an EX charge up there. And here comes some orbs.
They're gonna keep his distance. B-Kip has,
and this
really
is very smart because this variation doesn't have a projectile, so he doesn't have to deal with anything that she could potentially throw, even a shotgun.
Yeah, but
she has no range.
B-Kip does not have the life lead. He's gonna have to go in sooner or later.
Oh, we going into.
I don't know if B-Kip understands that or if he's trying to bait something.
And there's the health lead though.
Is this why he did it?
Is this real life?
What the hell is this?
We are witnessing the future of Mortal Kombat before our eyes!
I don't think there's anything high-tech can do without getting clipped.
I mean, at some point, Young is just gonna X-ray, right?
I assume so. He's gonna wait for the last second, but if B-Kip X-rays on his own, he might win that trade. But who keep his
distance? Oh, and he whips it! And that's gonna do a B-Kip in the full screen! That was ridiculous! This man has changed the meta! The meta has changed, ladies and gentlemen! Orbs are completely broken! This is ridiculous! Nerf it immediately!
Essentially, this is all B-Kip has to do. He technically has the life lead now based off the chip. Emma, is this really happening, man?
This is real life. This is the future of Mortal Kombat right here, guys. Get yourself a projectile or eat this force field around me. I am a thunder god, okay?
I honestly don't even know what to say. I mean, he's just letting the time run out. He's building all this meter. Young Monster's only option is to really use that X-ray if he stays away from him. There you go, scouts out.
This is good for Young, though. B-Kip was the one that broke early. And there we go, there's the X-ray!
Is it really gonna matter? I mean, even now, B-Kip is still gonna have the life lead after this X-ray, and now Young Monster has no meter to work with. Oh, just missed the conversion there. B-Kip is gonna take this match. I don't believe it.
Game number two. Now we'll see what Master of Storms can do against Full Auto.
See, now Orb's not gonna be too much in the play as it was before. Still getting that difficult to land 33%. But B-Kip is actually still making quick work of Monster here. To the point where he still has the life lead. And boom, just like that, B-Kip still taking the first round, even after Monster switches variations.
Round two, fight!
A little bit of chip damage in there.
This is a variation where really late in the game has started, we start to see more Master of Storms from guys like B-Kip. We see it from Gandyman all the time, where it took a long time to develop. Yeah, at that point, if I was B-Kip, don't let Young Monster build any more meter. Just start taking the hits. If you're getting flawless like that, Hood Perfect did in the corner, as it were.
Oh, and just blowing through
that.
Oh, and
the combo! The up rocket into... Oh my gosh. Into the traffic signal. And what a read on the wake up.
Wow, scouting out the vicinity blast. B-Kip just wasting all of his resources right now.
What a turnaround here from Young Monster. This is... I mean, anything on chip now. Any string. And Reed on!
Or just a raw up rocket, that works.
And that worked against the big boot because...
He really didn't seem too comfortable with if he goes into a game 5 situation. Just going for the stagger string. He's trying to get that first hit. Spends the bar to get another one back.
And he gets the max conversion, 32%. And that's what we were talking about earlier. It's such high execution, you don't see many in the scene able to do those combos consistently in two in a row.
And still.
Oh, and just getting him on the teleport mix.
Building a decent amount of meter doing it. Oh no. We know Jackie hits like a truck in the corner. Going for the mix! Very smart. Just try and use that armor, just make sure you secure that round. Putting yourself ever closer to a game 5.
Well, very good from Young to match that down 3 at that range, as Raidens are going to approach 9 times out of 10 with that forward 1. He wants to low profile it and get his big damage here in the corner off the mix. Has to watch out for teleport.
At this point, B-Kip is not going to use any of his resources. And just a standing one confirmed. Ooh. Taking that second round, putting him on set point.
Set point with a flawless.
Oh, narrowly missing that whiff punish there.
Luckily, that is 2 hits of armor. Oh, if he would have committed to the NJP, he had the right mindset to think that young monster was finally going to jump.
He's just trying to just kind of overwhelm him with this mobility right now, and hopes that he's going to open him up. And here we go, another full damage combo. Just drops the bare end of it. Young monster going for a little bit of damage here. Good hit confirmed by B-Kip, and he's going to take it. He's taking it. We are going to. And as we see now that he did, in fact, go back to high tech. Oh, and he's going to get a nice conversion off that beam that he hit at the peak of the jump. And even catching the backdash, too. And just look at that pressure. So hard to deal with.
Oh, and swinging. It's a monster. And staggering so much with stand one.
Oh, and a nice conversion there.
Look how much Young Monster still has. He can just stagger his way through this and hold on to this bar.
Oh my god.
And oh, here we go. Final round, fully loaded. Young Monster, one game away now. One round.
I mean, he's sitting on a full stick of butter there. He's just looking to dish out as much hit damage as he possibly can right now. Very nice by B-Kip getting the maximum damage off of that conversion.
And keeping it meterless and still doing great damage.
B-Kip has been doing really well as far as his execution is concerned.
Oh, it's been lights out. Here we go. With so much on the line, too. He's going to chip out down one. Shocker.
Absolutely. Down one shocker closes out. This is set point for both players. Young Monster still sitting on 3 bars. B-Kip a little bit under. Now sitting on almost 2 bars. But he has a lot of work to do. First step is definitely get out of that corner.
Teleports back into the corner. Savage Superman from B-Kip, but Young Monster has so much meter.
Oh, gets hit by that jump kick. B-Kip is not out of this just yet. He's not sitting on a lot of meter. Whoa! What was that?
Chris Angel Mind Freak stuff happening before our eyes. Finally drops
almost
one.
Another full damage combo. Still gets a good amount of damage at the same time. Really needs to be getting as much as possible.
Oh, he had the whip punish! Oh, but he doesn't commit! And Young Monster is going to put himself one combo away.
Hell, if
one
he
mix,
breathes,
one throw.
Now, miracles have happened before.
Oh, here we go!
The whip punish! Gonna keep him standing! Oh no!
And that's gonna do it, B-Kip! With the defense at the end is gonna take that! And Young Monster! Wow! Holy crap!
Believe it.
Holy crap is all I can say!